A T-Mobile hack impacts 37 million. New Android malware can edit your Wi-Fi router DNS settings. And a credential stuffing attack hits PayPal. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for January 24th, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. T-Mobile has experienced many data breaches in the past several years, including one in 2021 that affected about 40 million users, with a new one this year impacting 37 million customers. Names, email addresses, phone numbers, account numbers, and billing addresses for both prepaid and postpaid customers were stolen in this breach, but T-Mobile added that no sensitive data such as ID numbers, social security numbers, or payment information were obtained. T-Mobile disclosed this breach to the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission as legally required to do so, and it appears the hack happened on or around November 25th. Now, it was discovered on January 5th, 2023, so a little bit over a month later. T-Mobile found that an attacker used an API to gain access, and the problem was remediated within 24 hours of being discovered. Now, APIs are generally used by web services for data retrieval after authentication is complete, but if an API is not set up correctly, that can also lead to issues such as this one. T-Mobile has not explained exactly how this API was used to siphon off a bunch of data on their customers, but in the SEC filing, they explained that they are undergoing a years-long cybersecurity overhaul, and affected customers are currently being notified about the breach. Two new Android malware strains could allow an attacker to gain access to devices remotely and conduct phishing attacks, interact with the infected device in real time, and steal data. The first of these is called Hook. It appears to be based off a banking Trojan, which is called Ermac, which allowed attackers to steal credentials from banking and crypto apps. Researchers at Threat Fabric studied the code for Hook to find the similarities between the two types of malware. It's currently being sold as a malware for rent tool for about $7,000 per month. Now, unlike Ermac, though, Hook includes a VNC module which allows for interaction with the infected device in real time. This means the attacker could basically do anything they would want to on the device, but it would be harder to do on devices running newer operating system versions. This is because accessibility services access is required for the Hook VNC to work for the attacker. But Hook can also allow the attacker to see a full list of files on the device. They could exfiltrate data, track the device via geolocation, and messages could also be logged from popular applications like WhatsApp. Since Hook is distributed via the Google Chrome APK, you can basically avoid infection by only installing applications from within the Google Play Store. The second malware is called Roaming Mantis. It's unique due to its inclusion of a DNS changer, which can allow the attacker to modify DNS settings on Wi-Fi routers that happen to be vulnerable, which can also allow for this malware to be spread to other devices from the vulnerable router. Now, vulnerable routers are found via their model numbers on a network, and after they are detected, the malware changes the DNS settings. It then hijacks the DNS settings via this HTTP request, so clients connected to the Wi-Fi router would be redirected to malicious websites that could be used for phishing or further malware drops. Roaming Mantis has been around for several years, but the newest version of it consists of this Wi-Fi router targeting, and it spread via SMS phishing texts. As with Hook, this one also asks the user to install a malicious APK. If it detects a vulnerable router, it then tries to access the admin panel for the Wi-Fi router with default credentials. So, side note, make sure you change your router creds if you don't already do that. To avoid Roaming Mantis again, do not install APKs on your Android phone, only install apps from the Google Play Store, and do not click links sent via SMS. biggest of shout-outs to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies, for making this show possible since we do not have ads on the show at all. And a huge thank you to Aladdin6666, Ryan Regnehild, Scott, Melanie, and Lemon Kate for being a part of the s'mores at patreon.com/ShannonMorse. Now this year, I will be migrating all perks and early access content over to my Morse code Patreon and combining the two accounts to make releases and perks for y'all a lot more efficient. You can get ahead of this change by moving your pledge to patreon.com/ShannonMorse if you're already pledging on the ThreatWire Patreon. You will still get all of the perks associated with this Patreon with the added benefits of my Morse code perks for the same membership prices. For annual ThreatWire pledges, I would recommend and suggest keeping your annual pledge active until closer to your resubscription date and then switching over so you get the best bang for your buck. Let me know if you have any questions down below. And also my YouTube channel is youtube.com/ShannonMorse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. All of my CES content is wrapping up this week and I have got some reviews coming up some new gear. I'm super excited about it too. Do not forget to like and subscribe to Hack 5 as well. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, which is all about a PayPal credential stuffing attack. PayPal notified customers on January 18th about a data breach that happened in December that affected about 35,000 users. According to the notification and disclosure documents, the breach occurred from December 6th through 8th, and it was discovered on December 20th, and data such as social security numbers, usernames, addresses, tax ID numbers, and dates of birth may have been compromised, although no financial or banking information was obtained by the attackers. This happened via credential stuffing, where an attacker hits the site with several combos of usernames and passwords, usually obtained from previous leaks or data breaches, until they eventually get logged in. This can be done really quickly via the use of automation and bot techniques. Now, this is an important reminder why it's so important to use different passwords on all sites and enable two-factor or multi-factor authentication options. Affected customers are being notified and are required to reset their passwords upon next login. PayPal is also offering 2 years of identity theft monitoring via Equifax to affected users as well. Don't forget to subscribe again to the channel. I'm super excited. We are getting so close to our next big goal. And make sure to check out my site as well and my YouTube channel. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.